Hey guys, welcome back to another sales video. I thought I would bring you the latest sales from my shops on eBay, Etsy, Amazon. I've done pretty well, especially on eBay. Of course, Amazon is still generating quite a bit of sales with everything from books to mugs. So I still have quite a bit of listings there. And what I love about Amazon is that they stay there till they sell. Etsy as well, I did okay on Etsy. I sold a couple of things. One thing I sold on Etsy was this vintage brooch. This is a Christmas brooch, and of course I hoard and collect Christmas brooches. I've sold quite a few last year, and I don't think I have that many listed this year, but I did sell this one. I sold it for $10, and I believe I bought it for $1. One thing to look for on your vintage pieces is good quality rhinestones. You can tell immediately, even if it's not stamped, but if it's got a nice rhinestone, it's usually vintage. I also sold this pair for $45, guys. Remember when I showed it to you? I actually took you on a ride along when we found these, and they were only $1 a piece. Very, very excited to sell those on Amazon for $45 net. Then I bought this bag. This was a brand new bag, and this brand is from Hot Topic. It's called Cupcake Cult, and it's really, really cute. I got it for $4, and I sold it for, I believe, $20 on eBay, and so that was a good deal. I thought it looked really super cute. My daughter didn't say she really liked it, so I decided to go ahead and sell it. Every time I bring something for her, if she doesn't grab it within a couple of weeks and it's still sitting where I put it, I put it on for sale. This, guys, remember I bought this shirt? This is the Ralph Lauren flannel for $1 at that crazy garage sale with the gas leak. You guys went with me on that ride along. Everything at that garage sale was $1. Made out like a bandit at that garage sale. Really loved it. And so I sold this for $19 on eBay. People kept offering me $15, $14, $17, and I just said, no, I'll just wait. I thought it was a good deal. Did sell it for $19. This one is a Pendleton wallet with a beautiful wool blanket motif on it. I sold that for $39. I had it for $45, but I went ahead and lowered the price on my own accord. I usually do that. If it hasn't moved, in a while, I'll lower it down. Even a couple of dollars makes a difference because it brings it back up to the listing at the top. And so people like to see things in the top, and or they find them quicker that way. Anyway, so that was a good deal on that Pendleton wallet. Really loved it. That was a trifold wallet. This Gigapet, good deal on this one. Could not believe it. I got these for $1, and I still have quite a few of them. These are packaged. They are pristine. Sold it for $59. I could not believe it, but I did see a YouTuber talk about these, and I already had them. I kind of knew they were collectible. I have those in the Hit Clips. They're still packaged, so those are all listed at my Amazon, but this one I sold on eBay, $59. Some people are selling these for $400. I guess the rarity brings up the price. I don't know, but that one sold for $59. Sold this Mock Croc Vintage 9 West bag for $19, and I think I did take a best offer on that. I think I had it for $25 or $24, but I don't mind. I don't mind negotiating, haggling. It's all, we all like to, pretend we're getting a good deal, so I don't mind. It's better than putting it up there for another 3 months and it not selling, so I went ahead and let it go. I only paid $1 or so for it. This fossil, I paid $4 for it. Pristine, beautiful fossil bag. Sort of a jute, soft fabric with green leather trim. Really pretty bag. I showed you this in one of my hauls. Has quite a bit of compartments all over. Just really pretty pop of color there, and of course I take copious pictures, as I've mentioned to you guys before. The buyer wants to see it up close and personal because he can't touch it, can't see it. So if you provide enough pictures, they really get a good idea of what they're buying, and they're more likely to place that bid or buy it immediately when you convey those pictures. And I especially like live models because it does convey the size a lot more accurately to that buyer, even though they're reading the specs on it. Anyway, I got $80 on that Coach bag that I told you and showed you last week in my haul that I paid $10 for. Could not believe it. There was actually a bidding war going on for this bag. I was almost going to put it at a buy it now, but then I decided I'm gonna let it roll, and I did. And so yeah, it went for $80, guys, and that was a really, really good deal for me when I only got it for $10. So that more than paid for both my bags, for the one I kept. And someone's very happy with this beautiful messenger bag that's saddlebag style, saddlebag cut. Again, lots of good pictures on that. And yeah, that was a good deal. All right, then this one I got for $9. I think I showed you this as well. Not only in my haul, but in my what's in my bag. Beautiful fossil metallic. One of my subscribers had told me she liked it, but then she never got back to me about buying it. So I went ahead and listed it, and I did have it. I think I sold it for $45, and I had it for $50, I believe, but I went down on it. I did take an offer on that. It was the best offer I had gotten to because I got like three, but people were really lowballing it. Then this one had that little tiny flaw. It's a lot bigger in this picture. But, of course, I convey and reveal all flaws. Nobody wants to be surprised. Guys, thanks so much for joining me for my sales video. I really appreciate it. Please let me know how you like this video with your thumbs up. Bye.